Bonjour, I'm Richard Haines. I'm an artist and I live in Bushwick. It started with an immediate love of fashion when I was really, really young, not even really knowing what fashion was. There's an approach to beauty. I have always drawn. I started drawing when I was 4 or 5, when I could hold a pencil. And I moved to New York many years ago thinking I would be a hotshot illustrator, but at that time, illustration was kind of a shrinking industry, and I'd never studied it, so I was actually really intimidated by it to kind of make myself public with it. So I spent my career designing clothes for like Calvin Klein and Perry Ellis. And then in 2008, when the economy tanked and I could not find a job designing, I started a blog of illustrating because I really didn't know what else to do. This is my second to the best career.
What is it about the French culture that really resonates with you, and how did you become a Francophile?
Good question. It started with an immediate love of fashion when I was really, really young, not even really knowing what fashion was. And I remember when I was in college, and this is a really long time ago, I was the only person, I think, in all of Virginia and DC to get French Vogue. They would have to deliver it by hand from the post office, like to my house, because you couldn't find it anywhere. And it was just, I remember being completely obsessed with style, and it was more than just style. It was a point of view. It was a way of looking at beauty and art, and I would pore over those issues. I mean, I would look at American Vogue too, but I think, especially at the time, the editor of French Vogue, they were these incredible mixes of art and fashion. There were art, and there were kind of themes of like Lord Bacall or Alfred Hitchcock or I don't know, different French writers that were mixed in with fashion. And it was also this moment of Yves Saint Laurent kind of being the premier designer, and that was all happening in Paris, and photographers like Guy Bourdin. So it was really just this complete portal of French, it was really French culture. It wasn't just French fashion, it was French culture. So it was kind of getting everything in one magazine.
Mm-hmm. And did you start picking up some of the language through the magazine?
I did, yeah. I remember, this was when I was in high school. I was, I think, a sophomore in high school. And I remember walking into a class. It wasn't even a French class. I didn't study French. But I just remember saying out loud, "Does anyone know what de rigueur means?" And there was silence in the class. Like, this is like 1969 Virginia. It was just like, who is this guy? And so then when I graduated from college, my first big trip was going to Paris. And I was supposed to stay for like a week, and I kept delaying going back because I didn't want to go back to Washington. I would sit at Cafe Floor and watch people every day just walking to work. And then I realized I would see the same people going back and forth every day, and they'd wear the same suit, but with different accessories. But it was always the perfect suit. And as an American, it's like, buy as many things as you can, and then they fall apart. But I just was just like struck by this thing of like, we'll purchase one suit, but it'll be the most perfectly fitting, elegant suit, and we'll change it up, as opposed to like just having tons of stuff. And I thought that was so kind of innately chic and smart. I don't know, it's really unlike any other culture. There's kind of an acceptance of beauty, or an ease of beauty. So it just became this kind of innate love of all, I mean, literally all things French, just a complete obsession. I guess that's what makes someone a Francophile.
Yeah.
I'm obsessed with Versailles, and I've read so many books about Marie Antoinette, and the whole idea of kind of reconfiguring beauty and nature, and the way she kind of went against the court and then started wearing very kind of peasant-inspired clothes, but they were very elegant, very, of course, they were beautiful. So I don't know, maybe it's a combination of nature and beauty? I don't know what, I don't know.
I see you have a collection of vintage Vogues.
I do. This is actually one of my prized possessions. This is Vogue 1939, and it's really just a complete treasure. I mean, of illustration and photography and this moment of French fashion. I mean, this to me is just, it's breathtaking. And even the layout is so sophisticated and really kind of a an indication of what things would look like after the war. I mean, it's just, it's such a beautiful issue. So I love to pore over these magazines. It's incredible. Even just the cover, I mean, the idea that that's the cover of a magazine is pretty extraordinary. It's so kind of lovely. Yeah, it's very soft. I mean, it's a little sad because there's a dove, and it's, you know, I guess, did they know, but it's a really, really beautiful issue. That to me is just absolutely breathtaking. This is another beautiful piece for my collection. This is January 1936, Paris Vogue, cover by Eric. I mean, it's just complete perfection. And again, this incredible mix of photography, illustration, these drawings by Eric of evening clothes are beyond. Simple. It's a triple.